Hey, I'm Julie Bayfam Balzer, and if you have a Scan & Cut DX, you might have noticed there's a little lever on the left-hand side with the numbers 1 and 2, or maybe you've gotten the error message before that says adjust the scanner lever position and wondered what that is. Well, no fear, the logic is very easy to understand, and you don't actually really even have to understand it, you just have to know that it's time to switch it, which the machine will tell you every time. But if you're curious about the logic, here it is. So, inside your Scan & Cut is a scanner, and as part of that scanner, there is a sheet of glass. Now, in order to create a nice clean scan, that glass needs to be very close to whatever it's scanning, right? So that's position number one. However, when you're scanning thicker materials, because remember, the DX scans, or rather cuts, material up to 3 millimeters. So when you're cutting those thicker materials, you know, there's some worry that the scanner glass might get damaged. It might get scratched, it might get nicked or something like that. So in that case, they want the scanner glass to come up and away. So that's position number two. Now, it's not just getting nicked or scratched by something that's going into the machine to be cut. How about when you're drawing or you're foiling using a glue pen or something like that that is a little bit messy and you really don't want any of that ink or glue on your scanner glass? So again, the Scan & Cut is going to tell you, raise that glass to position two because they want to keep it nice and clean. So again, that's just the logic. If you want a nice, clean scan, one, if you're cutting thicker material or if you're using a pen or any ink or anything like that, it's going to want it up. You don't have to remember. The Scan & Cut DX will tell you, but I always think it's useful to know the logic. For more tips, tricks, and tutorials, be sure to visit my blog at balzerdesigns.typepad.com, subscribe to my YouTube channel, and of course, don't forget about the Scan & Cut website at scanandcut.com.